Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. Hope you guys are all doing well today. In this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to use the 1-inch DEX aggregator. And I'm also gonna give you guys a brief tutorial on small exchanges that are ideal for buying low cap tokens that aren't available on the larger exchanges. If you want to jump around the video or if you want the link to the exchange, make sure you guys check out the description box below. And I'd like to highlight that all the links below are my referral links. So if you guys sign up with any one of those, not only are you gonna help support my channel, but it also makes you eligible for a small bonus or discount on your trades. And if you guys have any questions after watching my video, you can of course express those inquiries in the comment section below. But I also encourage you guys to check out my Discord channel. Not only is it a good venue for you guys to connect with like-minded individuals, but it's also a good place for individuals who have technical difficulties or who are having a hard time finding a certain token. So if you have any interest of joining a robust community of 1,000+ members, make sure you guys check out the Discord link in the description below. With the intro out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into this video. All right, to get started, let me show you guys how to use this DEX aggregator called 1-inch Exchange. Recently, I've been making a lot of videos on Polkadot because I think that ecosystem is just ready to explode. And in this bull cycle, I expect a lot of those tokens to perform well. But many of those tokens aren't listed on large exchanges, and sometimes the exchanges that you want to access require KYC. 1-inch, on the other hand, doesn't require any KYC, so anybody in the world with internet connection can access it. And what it does is it aggregates orders across multiple decentralized exchanges. This way, in theory, users should get the best price with the least amount of slippage. Now, this option may not be economically viable for everybody, because as we head into this bull market, there's a good chance that the gas fees for Ethereum are gonna go up. So if you're only planning to invest a couple $100, you might end up paying $20 to $40 just in fees to execute your trade. And so if you're on that boat, I would recommend checking out the other trading venues, which I've linked in the timestamp below. But anyhow, to get started, first you need to connect your wallet. And the 1-inch aggregator gives you a lot of options. You can use your Ledger, and if you have a mobile application like Trust Wallet, which basically allows you to have a crypto wallet on your phone, just access the app that supports Wallet Connect on your phone. Click here on Wallet Connect, scan the QR code with your phone. Once you scan the QR code, your phone will prompt you to confirm the connection. Once you confirm the connection on your phone, you'll be ready to go. The easiest option is probably MetaMask. All you need to do is set up an account, fund it with some Ethereum, and you're ready to go. Once you've connected with the wallet of choice, down here, you're gonna see a display of your transaction history. So any transactions that you made with this wallet on 1-inch are gonna be displayed here at the bottom. And remember folks, make sure you guys have enough Ethereum to pay for the transaction fees. Once you're done with all that, all you need to do is pick the asset you want to sell and pick the asset you want to buy. So for example, let's say I wanted to get rid of my GVT. I can just click here on GVT. And at the bottom here, let's say I wanted to buy some XRT, which I recently did a review on and I encourage you guys to check that out. But let's go ahead and click here. If I execute this transaction, my GVT will be converted to wrapped Ethereum, which will be converted to Ethereum, and my Ethereum will be converted to XRT on Uniswap. And let's say the token that you want, you know it's available on a different decentralized exchange, but maybe it's not populating here on 1-inch. For example, I know for sure Rune is listed on SushiSwap, but for whatever reason, it's not available here on 1-inch. In this case, I would go over here to Etherscan, type in the token of interest, in this case it's Rune, click on the token, copy the contract address, come back here to 1-inch, click here on add token, copy and paste the token address here, and you'll see that Rune will populate, and then I'll go ahead and click on add token. By the way, if you wanted to switch these two, for example, I wanted to pay with XRT and receive rune, I can just click here and the two fields will flip. Now to execute this trade, you're gonna have to unlock your address because the smart contract can't interact with the tokens in your wallet unless you give it permission. So to give it permission, you're gonna have to click here on this lock. Safest bet is using this option here to the left because it'll unlock your wallet for a one-time transaction. But if you're planning to make more than one transaction, then this is probably the best option because you'll pay one time versus paying multiple times by using this option here. But it's also a little bit more risky because it'll give the protocol or the smart contracts infinite access to the token that you're unlocking. Once you unlock your tokens, all you need to do is submit the trade and confirm the transaction on the device that you're using. It'll take a minute for the Ethereum network to confirm your transaction, but once your transaction is confirmed, you'll receive the tokens that you bought. Hotbit is the first exchange we're gonna cover. This exchange doesn't require its users to do a KYC. In fact, 90% of its users are from overseas. This exchange went live sometime around January 2018. To my knowledge, it hasn't lost any of its users' funds, but that fact alone doesn't mean your funds are going to be safe on the exchange. I personally don't keep a large sum on this platform, although I do know some people that do, and they're okay with that risk. In fact, one of my patrons loves this platform. He uses it all the time. Because in addition to buying low cap alts or alts that aren't accessible on larger exchanges, they also have these interest yielding products. And as you can see here, the yields are very robust. And the patron that I was referring to earlier, he's been using the platform for a while and he's very happy with the services that he's been rendered. Now, in terms of liquidity, out of all the exchanges that I'm going to present today, it's probably the top two. But just like on any other exchange, if you're trading a pair that was newly listed and that's a new coin, make sure you guys pay attention to the slippage. Next up, we have Probit, which is a Korean-based exchange. Unlike Hotbit, you'll have to do a KYC if you want to use all the features offered by the platform. And this is a very new exchange. And so for that reason, the liquidity profile of most of the tokens that are listed here tends to be very poor. But if you're only trading a couple hundred thousand dollars or a few thousand dollars, you should have very little problem going in and out certain positions. They sometimes host these exclusive offers. For example, starting in 7 days and 4 hours, you'll be able to buy Bitcoin at a 50% discount. The allocation for this promo is $50,000. I haven't participated in IEOs myself, but they provide you with that option if you guys decide to use this exchange. Additionally, they also have a staking service. For example, they're gonna allow you to stake your Ethereum for Ethereum 2.0. Next up, we have Bilexi. It's another exchange that requires you to do a KYC. If you're not planning to trade with size, for example, if you're trading 200 ETH or less, you don't need to do the advanced KYC. You can just do the primary KYC where you just give your full name. And like Probit, the liquidity profile of this exchange is very poor. But what I really like about this exchange is the fact it tends to be the first exchange to list high quality, low cap DeFi projects. I wouldn't be surprised if they have a team dedicated to finding low cap gems. Sometimes when I'm doing my own research for low cap gems, I'll go over here to Bilexi just to see which tokens they've recently added to their exchange. Next up, we have BitTrue. You can get away with not doing a KYC on this platform, but if you want to take out a loan, for example, using your crypto as collateral, you'll have to do a KYC. And compared to the previous two exchanges that I covered, the liquidity profile of tokens here on this exchange is a lot better. In addition to taking out loans against your crypto assets, you can also earn a yield on certain crypto assets that they support in PowerPiggy. In fact, I have a good chunk of my LINK here in PowerPiggy earning me 5.3%. And if you buy their exchange token, BTR, you can participate in BTR lockups where you can earn very large yields on your crypto assets. In fact, my buddy loves BitTrue. He writes monthly reports on the platform. And in those reports, he details how much he's earned by putting his assets to work on BitTrue. If you guys wanted to learn more about BitTrue, BitTrue's PowerPiggy program, BitTrue lockups, I encourage you guys to check out my BitTrue playlist. I provide a more detailed tutorial of how the platform works. And lastly, we have Binance International. This is different from Binance US. Technically speaking, US citizens aren't allowed to use the exchange, but my subscribers have told me that they've had no problem if they use a VPN. And if you guys decide to take that route, just know that if Binance finds out, there's a chance that they might freeze your funds. But if you're outside the US and you can legally use the platform without using a VPN, I would strongly encourage you guys to use the exchange. Out of all the exchanges that I've talked about today and all the exchanges that I've ever used, Binance by far is my favorite. The liquidity on this exchange is deep as it gets, and they support numerous pairs, numerous tokens, and they're constantly adding features to optimize the experience of the user. So if you're new to crypto and you live in a jurisdiction that doesn't prohibit you from using Binance, I would strongly recommend that you guys create an account here with Binance. Now to wrap up the video, I'd recommend that you guys make an account with all these exchanges. This way, if you find a token of interest, you'll already have an account set up. All you need to do is send your funds there, make the trade, and based on the risk profile of the exchange, you can either leave those assets on the exchange or withdraw them to your wallets. And generally speaking, if you're looking for a token to buy, the best thing to do is come over here to coingecko.com. And let's say, for example, you wanted to buy the XRT token. You scroll down here to the bottom after going to the token page. From there, you look at the exchanges that it's listed on. And you can see here right off the bat, it's on two of the exchanges that I mentioned to you guys today. And also, if you notice, it's listed here on Bancor, which is a decentralized exchange, and Uniswap, which is also a decentralized exchange. Which means you can also come here to 1inch, the DEX aggregator I talked about earlier in my video, to buy the token. And it's very likely that a lot of the Polkadot plays that I cover in my videos, they're going to start off as ERC-20 tokens until mainnet goes live and they become a pair chain on Polkadot. And I have a feeling that a lot of these pair chains are always going to have an ERC-20 version of their token. Because number one, it'll improve the liquidity profile of their token. And secondly, when things are cross-chain compatible, Ethereum users will be able to access the services provided by the respective protocol. And if you're still having trouble with any of this after watching this video, and maybe you need further guidance and support, or maybe you just want to expedite your learning, if that sounds like you, I would strongly recommend checking out my Patreon page. There you can access a wide variety of crypto-related services I offer. And if you join one of the higher tiers, you can even have one-on-one dialogue with me. And by leveraging the years of experience and knowledge I have, you could potentially leapfrog a lot of your peers that are just entering the market. So if you wanted to take full advantage of the super cycle that we're about to enter, consider checking out my Patreon page by clicking the link in the description below. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video and you guys absolutely kill it in this upcoming bull run. This is Crypto One Step signing out. I'll talk to you folks next time. Bye.